Yeah, I love Brian's story. I remember profiling him and spending a few days with him and his daughter, Jenna. And in the course of writing that very long investigative report of his life, I actually interviewed a number of his relatives, people he'd worked with in the music industry. And I think people are taken with Brian's story because the transformation is so radical. There's no other way to explain a 10-year meth addiction suddenly being cured.
I went home with my drugs, and I just poured my heart out to God. I said, God, these drugs are gonna kill me and leave my daughter without a dad. Please, if you're real, come into my life, give me a new life. And with a long story short, I just had an encounter with God's love within the next few weeks. And I felt like Jesus came in and put his arms around me.
There's no way to explain someone who was part of a band whose lyrics were about suicide and death all of a sudden becoming full of hope and life. And Brian is what I call living proof that Jesus is alive today and he's transforming people today. I believe that's part of why Christianity is the largest movement in world history and the fastest growing, now with 2.4 billion people in the world, because when people believe, when they truly believe, they change, they transform.
I felt like I was at home for the first time.
Hey guys, thanks for checking out 100 Huntley Street.
You know, I was really inspired by today's stories, and you can check out our page, thousands and thousands of other life-changing stories that we'll share right here.